everyone. Welcome to OPI's Tech Talk with CosmoProf. My name is Sigourney Nunez, and I'm OPI's North America Education Manager. And today I'm super excited to introduce you to Diana Nguyen.
Hi, guys.
Diana, what's your name on Instagram?
Rice Kitty Nails. You guys can follow me on social media at Rice Kitty Nails on Instagram and Facebook.
If you don't follow Diana already, she's really great at really cute nail art. So today we're super excited to be using our brand new Hello Kitty collection and our gel color finish to walk you through some really amazing holiday nail art looks. We're also going to be giving away some really major gel color prizes, so stay tuned for that. So what's the first look you're going to show us?
Okay, so I have like three different looks, but the first look is this pink glitter gradient. Perfect for the holidays. And the colors that I use for this design is Husha Blush, and Born to Sparkle. And Husha Blush is like a pearly pink, light pink color. And I already painted one coat of the color on the nail tip and cured it for 30 seconds. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add another coat just to make it a little bit more opaque. Mm-hmm. Usually when I paint clients, I put like two coats.
Right.
But what I like to do is like paint another coat like this.
Very pretty.
Yes, I really love this color. I actually have this color on my nails right now, too.
Yeah, I would love for you to show it off as soon as that color cures.
Yeah, I'll show you guys.
Cool.
Okay, so this is like the second coat.
Pretty.
And then we're going to cure it into the gel machine for 30 seconds.
Awesome.
And then after, I'll show you guys what I have on my nails.
Love it.
Okay.
And then I want to show you guys one of the giveaways that we're going to be doing. We're giving away five full sets of our OPI gel color in the Hello Kitty collection. All you have to do to enter is follow us on Instagram at @OPI_professionals, then like CosmoProf on Facebook,
okay.
And then tell us what your favorite OPI gel color shade is. Do you have one, Diana?
Yes, it's what I have on my nails, Husha Blush. Also,
Pretty nice. I also
have this color too.
Super pretty.
It's called
Let Love Sparkle.
Let Love Sparkle.
I got you, girl.
Yes, you got me.
Yep.
Okay. And then after that is finished curing, what I like to do is kind of grab like a nail palette, like looks like this, and then place the Born to Sparkle onto the palette like so. Mm-hmm. And I just want to like pack enough so it's enough for me to like grab it.
Okay.
And then I'm going to grab one of the OPI Gel Color Art Series brushes and grab some of the glitter and then pile some on, starting from the tips, and then work your way up to start like this gradient look. But I like to tap here and there. Hold on, let me see, sorry.
What I really love about this color is that it does have those chunky glitter flakes, which is really cool that we don't really hardly see with OPI gel color specifically. So super excited to introduce these limited edition shades that are available on CosmoProf right now.
Oh my God, that's amazing. Okay, so after, I'm just gonna, like a pro tip I like to use, like since I'm adding like the glitter on the palette, you could just grab some of the glitter instead of like the gel. Cause if you kind of just brush on the gel onto the nail tip, mm-hmm. it'll create like this lumpy effect on the nail. So if you wanna avoid that, just place it onto the nail palette and then just grab like a separate brush and kind of just like dab it onto the tip of the nail.
And it's kind of like sponging, but with gel in a way, right?
Yeah, kind of like sponging, exactly. Yeah, you could also use a sponge for this technique as well.
I think this is a really perfect look for the holiday season all the way through New Year's.
Yes, it's so fun and girly and pretty. It's perfect.
If you have any questions for Rice Kitty on the techniques that she's using or any of the shades, let us know in the comments below and also tell us where you're watching from.
Yes. Okay. You could always build up like the gradient, but I'm just gonna do the first layer real quick so it won't look too like chunky.
Sure.
And place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds.
So you're doing a full cure on that?
Yeah, I'm doing a full cure just to make sure like it doesn't like wrinkle or anything on me.
Great.
Yeah, so I'm gonna grab a little bit more of the glitter and then place it into or onto the nail polish so I have more glitter to add onto the design.
Looks great so far.
Yes.
In addition to our full sets of gel color, we also have some really cute stocking stuffers with nail lacquer minis.
Nail lacquers. Oh my god, are those the tiny ones?
Little baby nail lacquers in the Hello Kitty shades.
Oh my god, I love the packaging. It's so cute.
So to enter for this, all you have to do also like follow us on Instagram at OPI_professionals, then like Cosmoprof on Facebook. And then just tell us who that special person is who you'd love to give this to this holiday season.
Yes. Oh my god, I love that.
Who would you give that to?
I'll give that to my best friend.
Okay, well, you're a good friend. I keep my own.
I'll buy another one. Well, is there like a place where you could buy it to if you don't like win the giveaway?
Yeah, really good question. Yeah. So all of the items that we're showing today are available at your local Cosmoprof and also CosmoprofBeauty.com.
Oh, okay. Right. Perfect. Okay, so once that is finished, I'm gonna grab like one of the flat brushes again, and then kind of grab some of the glitter and add it to the tips of the nail just to build more of the glitter gradient, like so. And I just like how you mentioned like it's like a chunky glitter, so it just gives you a different dimension to the design too.
Love it.
Yeah, it's so cute.
I love that it's monochromatic too, so it makes it really pretty, like pink on pink.
Yeah, I love pink. That's like one of my favorite colors.
You don't say.
I mean, yeah. Okay, so then once that is finished, I'm gonna cure it for like another 30 seconds into the gel machine. And click that.
Love it.
And then where's the top coat? This one, right?
Yep. Top coat's always gonna be with the white cap.
Oh, yes. Yep. Perfect. Okay, so we're gonna wait for that to cure for 30 seconds. And are there any questions like on like Facebook?
So I'm checking Facebook right now. Yeah. We have Chantel saying, so cute.
Okay.
We have Nicole saying, I love Hush of Blush.
Let's be friends. Me too. Then, let's be friends. Is that one of the colors that just came back?
I'm so glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
Do you want to introduce her?
Oh my god, let's be friends. Have you guys seen this color? It came back, it came out like in 2016, right?
Yeah. So diehard OPI fans know that back in 2016, we launched a collection with Hello Kitty where we launched Let's Be Friends and people fell in love. But just like the 2016 version and this version, they're both limited edition collections. So get your hands on it now if you really love it. Available at Cosmoprof.
Oh my god. It's just limited time. You can only get it once.
Limited edition only. What's on shelf now is what's on shelf only.
I'm going to put this
in
my pocket.
So get your hands on it.
I love that color. It's so cute. Okay, and then after it's finished curing into the gel machine, we're going to add one coat of top coat.
Yep.
Just to add a beautiful shine to the nail and conceal everything together.
Yep. What I love about the OPI gel color system is when you use our base, two coats of color, and our top coat, you can get up to 3 weeks of wear and an easy 15-minute removal.
Yeah, and we're gonna cure this for 30 seconds into the gel machine. Like so.
Awesome.
Yes.
We've got Melissa on Facebook saying, Let's Be Friends is my favorite Hello Kitty gel.
Oh my god, yeah. It's so pretty. It's kind of like a powdery pinky color. Yep. It's not too pink, but it's like a light pink.
Like a milky pink.
Yeah. It's a beautiful color.
Yeah. So in addition to Hush of Blush, what else do you have on your nails?
Oh, right now I have glitters.
Let Love Sparkle.
Let Love Sparkle. All right. Which is like a kind of like a pearly light blue. I could also see like some of the blue micro glitters in there too.
Yeah, it's got like a pearlescent finish. Yeah. For those of you who are looking for an effects change.
Sure.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Yeah, I like to just paint my nails like two different colors.
Love it.
Yeah. Okay, so once it's cured into the gel machine, there's like a slight tacky layer. Yep. So what I like to do is grab one of the lint-free wipes and kind of saturate it with alcohol.
Yep.
And wipe the tacky layer off, and then you should get a nice smooth layer.
It looks really good.
Oh my god, it's such a cute design. Okay, next I'm gonna show you my set. Oh, also if you want like a darker alternative color to use for this design, I like to use this color called Hello Pretty. Is it Hello Pretty? Oh no,
my favorite gal pal.
Yeah, my favorite gal pal, which is like a dark blue color. And what I like to use for this type of glitter is called Glitter to My Heart.
Yep.
Which is like a really pretty white, snowy, like I chose that glitter just because I feel like it kind of reminds me of the snow, and it's perfect for like the holiday season. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
So I feel like there's not that many people that are really excited about this giveaway right now.
And oh, really? Why?
I'm not sure, but I'm going to remind everyone.
Wait, how do you enter again?
So we're giving away five full sets
five?
Of our OPI Hello Kitty Gel Color Collection. Five full sets.
Five.
And all you have to do is follow us on Instagram at OPI_professionals. Then like CosmoProf on Facebook, and then tell us what your favorite OPI gel color shade from the Hello Kitty collection is. Cool?
Oh, okay.
That's easy enough.
Yeah, right.
Awesome.
Is there like a way to like type it out, or like the giveaway thing, or?
Yeah, I'm telling people backstage helping us.
Yeah, okay.
I was like, maybe those of you who are not watching with audio, maybe they can type it in the comments. That would be super helpful.
Yeah, for
cool,
sure.
Great idea.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, so the next design I'm going to show you guys is snowflakes, sparkle snowflakes that I like to use or for the holiday season. So the color that I use is called Let's Be Friends.
Yep.
One of the iconic colors. And I already painted one coat of Let's Be Friends onto this knot tip already, just to save a little bit of time. And I'm gonna paint like another coat just to make it a little bit more opaque. But if the second coat isn't opaque enough for you, you could always paint an additional third coat.
Right.
Yeah. Just to get like the full color if you
Very
like.
Good.
Yeah. So I'm gonna paint one more coat. Sorry, I didn't want to get like glitter on my
shirt.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna paint one. This is the second coat.
Okay.
And then, oh my god, this color is so pretty. It's like a creamy color.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. Okay, and then we're gonna cure that into the gel machine for. We're going to cure that from the gel machine for 30 seconds.
Wonderful.
Yes.
Hey, Sig and Rice Kitty.
Hey.
I want you guys to know that on Instagram, we have people watching from India, the UK,
Peru,
Maryland, Nebraska.
Really?
Wow. And Nailgasms says you guys are so stylish with the fresh hair color.
Oh, my God. Thank you, Nago.
Hey, Brittany.
How are you doing? Thank you so much.
So cute. Awesome. Thank you for the love.
Oh, yeah. Thank you so much.
We have Angie saying my fave is Let's Be Friends. I don't have Instagram. Thanks for the chance to win some awesome products.
Oh, okay. Okay, so once that is finished curing into the gel machine for like 30 seconds, I'm going to go in and grab my nail palette again. Oh, did you help me wipe that off?
Did.
Oh my God, thank you so much. She got my bag, girl. She got my bag. So then after, I'm going to grab one of the kind of like, it's the Gel Color Artist Series, their liner brush. I'm going to grab that, and I'm going to grab this color, All About the Bows.
Nice.
Which is a beautiful red color.
It's the color I have on.
Oh, really? Let me see. Let me see your nails.
Sneaky
Show them
peaky.
Off. Oh, my God. Look
French
at this
glitter.
This glitter is amazing. Oh, my God. I just love how, like, she added the glitter as, like, negative space.
Oh.
Yeah. And then it's just, like, so cute.
Thanks,
Rizky. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to try to open this. Okay. There you go. I kind of put, like.
Really okay.
And also, I put like lotion before the show. I don't want my hands to look all ashy on camera. Yeah, okay.
You did great, girl.
All right, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Okay, and then I'm just gonna put some of the All About the Bows into the nail palette, and then grab, if you guys can see, and then grab some of the color onto the liner brush, and then start creating like, I'm gonna do like a plus sign. So I'm just gonna kind of saturate the color into the brush. So then when I'm painting onto the nail, it's like easier for you to like get the color onto the design.
Cool.
Okay, so I'm just gonna go like up. So I'm doing like a vertical line, and then I'm gonna do like a horizontal line like so.
The room got so quiet.
Oh my God. Is there any questions like on Facebook or anything that people are saying?
I'm looking at Facebook now. No questions so far other than I love it. And then all about the bows, yes.
Yes, all about the bows. Okay, and then after I'm gonna do like an X, a diagonal line like in between, like so. To create like the snowflake look. And then after that, you know how like the snowflake has like the little like arms?
Yes.
And creating like little arms like
cute. On
the ends of the plus signs
makes
that
sense.
We created.
Yep. Following you, yeah.
Yeah. And then I'm gonna do it just on like the up and down lines and then the left to right lines and then it's so funny like whenever I do like designs like I feel like I'm so focused
it is like, so quiet right now
yeah
and we're all just respecting your artistry and we're all in awe. Nail Luscious on Instagram says wow you make it look so easy.
Oh my God, thanks girl.
And then Nailgasm says, how do you stay so steady?
Oh, what I like to do is I like to like kind of place my finger on like something like this and then like kind of, I'm actually placing my elbow on the table.
Yep.
Yeah, so I have something to stable myself in my hand when I'm placing the design or creating the design. And then after we finish this snowflake, we're gonna place it into the gel machine for like 30 seconds.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. And then wait for like, oh, I'm gonna pull out another color too.
Great.
Yeah.
If you're just joining us, we are with Diana Nguyen, also known as Rice Kitty Nails on Instagram.
Hi,
and she's showing us three beautiful holiday nail art looks using our brand new Hello Kitty collection.
Yes.
Awesome.
Yeah, I'll show you guys like a sneak peek of like the third one. I'll like place it into like, so that we created already
yep.
this look already.
Yep.
But if you want like another alternative, it would be like this look.
Just mix up the shades.
Yeah,
really
just mix up the shades. And then right now we're working on this snowflake design. And then after, we're gonna show you guys the Hello Kitty bow.
Great.
Okay. Oh. Oops.
No biggie.
Okay, so we just finished curing this design, the snowflake that we did, for like 30 seconds.
Yep.
And then we're gonna grab my favorite gal pal. And I'm gonna place this in the table. And then I'm gonna try to open this. Hey, Sid, can you help me?
I have sweaty hands right now.
It's okay.
But maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Magic. Something. Ta-da.
There you go. Oh my God. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, so I'm using my favorite gal pal, which is like a dark navy blue color.
I love
a good blue girl. Yes, it's a beautiful navy blue color. And then since we placed that onto the nail palette, I like to just wipe like the excess of the gel from the brush.
Is there anything on your wipe right now or is it dry?
It's actually saturated with alcohol.
Okay.
So just to like make sure you just remove the gel from the brush. And then after, I'm gonna saturate the brush again with my favorite gal pal. And then I'm gonna do another snowflake, but in like a dark navy blue color.
Cool.
Onto the opposite direction, so.
We got a great question on Instagram. How can I fix, if someone's doing intricate nail art, how can I fix it if they make a mistake? Like in this example, if the line is shaky, what should they do?
Oh, okay. So what I like to do to fix like a mistake that you did, like I did on the line, what I like to do is just kind of grab like some of the alcohol onto here. I don't know if you guys can see it.
Yeah.
Yeah, grab some alcohol and grab like a cleanup brush and kind of like grab some of the alcohol. And then say you made a mistake, you can always brush it or clean it off with the brush, like so, like that.
Yep.
Yeah, just clean it up if you made a mistake.
Yeah, I think it's important to note too that Diana is using gel color for this.
Yeah.
So the mistakes that were done were not cured yet, so she can't easily wipe them off and redo them.
Yes, yeah, definitely.
Cool, thank you.
Mm-hmm. No problem. So we're gonna do the second snowflake onto the opposite direction, kind of below the nail. I already did one on top, so I'm just gonna create like a vertical line in the corner of the nail. And then after, I'm gonna do like a horizontal line, kind of creating like a plus sign.
Yep.
And then I'm gonna do like a diagonal line in the middle, like so, kind of creating like an X.
Hey, Rice Kitty.
Yes.
I got a question on Facebook. What kind of brush are you using for this design?
I'm using the OPI Gel Color Artist Series. It comes in like a nice traveling wallet case. Yeah. So it comes with like a lot of brushes. So there's like, I like how like there's like this thicker brush, kind of reminds me of like an eyeshadow brush, but oh, there you go. So this is
like
a nice
wallet.
Yeah, it's like a nice wallet, but actually when you do open it, it comes in like a nice like pouch where you could just add your brushes in here to keep in track, nice to travel with. And it comes with like a kind of like a round brush, dotting tool.
Yep.
There's like a big one and a small one. Mm-hmm. It comes with a liner brush, and then also like another cleanup brush too. I like to use this for a cleanup brush. But can they purchase this online too, or?
Yes, you can definitely check it out at cosmoprofbeauty.com.
Oh, they have it too? Okay, perfect. Yeah, this could be like a great gift too.
Yes, for your nail pro friends.
For your nail pro friends, yes. I really like the liner brush. It's very precise. Okay, so after I created like kind of like a starry look, we're gonna create like another like small, we're gonna add small lines, kind of like 45 degree angle onto the lines we created, just like the ends of it, to create like that snowflake effect to the nails. Yeah, I just like this look. I think it's so popular during the holidays.
Yeah, I mean, snowflake nail art is definitely one of those most requested designs during the holidays,
yes,
for sure.
Yeah. Yeah, so after we finish creating that look, we're going to add it or place it into the gel machine for like 30 seconds.
Great.
And then cure.
We did get a question specifically about your glitter gradient.
Yeah.
Loved it. How do you cap the free edge when you're applying the glitter? Do you cap the free edge with the glitter at all? Is it just with the base color underneath or just the top coat?
With the top coat.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I like to, like, if you want to, like, conceal the design, I like to place just one coat of, like, the top coat and then kind of just, like, use the ends of the brush and then just kind of cap it.
Perfect.
To seal everything together.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
And why is it so important to cap the free edge?
Just because I feel like a lot of like clients or people in general, they like to use like the tips of their nails a lot. So that's like what you see that like kind of chips.
Yeah.
For the most part. But by capping the tips of the nail helps prevent from like chipping.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. So once that is finished, I like to add glitter, more glitter.
Yes.
So I'm going to add Let's Celebrate. I like to add like glitter, especially for our snowflakes, just to add like a kind of like a snow falling, like snow, yeah, into the design. So, oh my God, this color is so pretty. Okay, so I'm just gonna use like the brush. Actually, you know what? I'm just gonna do this because I wanna make sure the nail isn't gonna be like lumpy when I add the glitter. So I'm gonna add Let's Celebrate onto the nail palette and then grab one of the kind of like a flat brush and kind of get some of the excess gel out. And then we're gonna place some of the glitter to grab some of the glittery effect to give it that snowy look.
Love it.
sparkly, sparkle snowflakes.
Yeah, that's one of the really cool things about this collection is we have a variety of glitter shades, but a variety of glitter sizes too.
I love that. I love it. I love how like you like did it on your nails, just like that. It's so girly and cute. I love it.
Nailgasm said that she's already, even though we're in mid-October, she's already getting a lot of snowflake nail art requests.
Oh my god, yes! I love that. It's so much fun. You could always like play around with like snowflakes too. There's like all
like
different...
Like you did with colored
snowflakes. Yeah, with like different colors. I like how like Let's Celebrate kind of has like micro holographic like glitter in there too. So it's just kind of sparkles, like kind of rainbowy effect.
Yep, totally.
Yeah, so cool. So I just kind of added just around like the empty spaces. I didn't really add like the glitter onto the snowflake, but it's just like kind of around where I see like the empty areas.
Yep.
Like so. And then if you want to add more glitter, we can on the next round. Cool. But I'm just going to place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds.
Great. I have another question about capping the free edge, but specifically regarding clients with bitten nails or really short nails. What do you do for those?
If their nails are short?
Yep. How, at what point do you cap the free edge and how do you prevent it from the gel like getting on the skin?
Oh, if the gel does get onto the skin, what I like to do is get like a flat brush like this and then kind of grab some of the alcohol.
Yep.
And then kind of just wipe it underneath and just those areas where you see there's like paint on the skin. I just wipe it off before you cure it.
Cool.
Yeah. So once that is finished curing into the gel machine, if you want to add more glitter, it's optional, but I really like how this amount of glitter looks. So I'm just going to add just like one coat of top coat.
Perfect.
Just to seal in the design.
Cool.
Like so. And then I'm going to show you how I cap like the tips of the nails too.
Perfect.
Just like that. Just like the ends, like so. And then we're going to place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds.
Cool. Someone named Jill on Instagram says, can you do that glitter gradient again for me, please?
Oh, yeah, of course.
So our live is going to be available to replay on YouTube, on our Instagram at OPI _ professionals. So if there's anything you miss, you can definitely rewatch it later.
Okay.
But really great request.
Yeah, I mean, if they want to see it. And if we do have time, we can.
No problem.
Yeah,
you're so
let
generous.
Me know. Yeah. Yeah, let me know.
And then also got a question about the gel lamp. Lots of the products you see here today are available at Cosmoprof and CosmoprofBeauty.com, which reminds me that we are doing some major giveaways. The first of two is really super adorable mini nail lacquer kits featuring our Hello Kitty shades.
So
for this, to enter, all you have to do is follow us at OPI_professionals on Instagram and like Cosmoprof on Facebook, and then tell us who you would gift this to, someone special in your life. Then we have five full sets of the gel color OPI Hello Kitty collection. Similar rules, but for this, follow us on Instagram at OPI_professionals, then like Cosmoprof on Facebook, and then tell us what your favorite gel color shade is in this OPI Hello Kitty collection.
Okay.
Easy enough, right,
Easy enough. I noticed there was like blue bows and red bows on that packaging too. Are both of them like the same set? Or you?
Really good
the
question.
The whole thing is like a set.
There are 15 shades in the entire collection.
Oh, okay,
Three of our exclusive glitter shades, but here we have 12.
Okay.
And so one set features six different colors, and then the other one features another set of colors that you can see sort of see there.
Yeah. Oh, I see. They have like
the swatches on the bottom.
The swatches in the corner. Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
Nice.
Great.
Okay, so once that is cured into the gel machine, I already applied one coat of top coat already, so there's like a tacky layer.
Yep.
So I'm going to grab one of the lint-free wipes and kind of soak it with alcohol and wipe the tacky layer away. And then you have a beautiful, shiny, sparkle snowflake.
Love it.
Yes.
Kawaii.
Okay. Kawaii. Okay, and then after, we're going to show you how to do this Hello Kitty bow design.
Awesome.
Sparkly.
Yay.
Okay. So I'm just going to kind of turn this over just in case. But I already paint one coat of Let's Be Friends mm-hmm. onto this nail tip already. So I'm going to paint one more coat just to give more opaqueness to the yep. nail. So here's one coat. Oh, second coat, sorry. This is the second coat. Onto the nail.
Yep.
And then I'm gonna cure it into the gel machine for 30 seconds.
Awesome,
there you go. I just love gel. I just love how fast it cures into the machine.
Okay.
Only 30 seconds.
So you love gel because it cures fast.
Yeah, and no if you make time. Yeah, and if yeah. you do make a mistake, it's always forgiving where you can just like wipe it off and yeah. don't have to worry about like the other layers that you have underneath.
Right.
It's already dry, so it's like amazing.
Cool. Earlier somebody did ask, they are a nail art newbie, so what would they do if say they work a little bit slower yeah. and so sometimes you notice that the gel tends to like pull a little bit. Do you recommend flash curing for something like that?
So what I like to do when I do work on clients, mm-hmm. I just paint like two nails.
Okay.
And then I have them like placed into the gel machine. Yeah. And while that hand is in that gel machine, I work on the other hand.
Cool.
And I paint two fingers
nice.
At the same time. And cool. then we switch off.
Okay.
Yeah. And then after I paint like two and then I save the thumb one at a time.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, it was a shop. Yeah, nice. Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah, so once that is cured into the gel machine, I'm gonna do the Hello Kitty bow.
Yep.
So
yay.
We're gonna grab what's this color? All about the bows.
Naturally.
Yeah. I'm gonna get like the dotting tool and kinda tap. Let me see the red. All about the bows. There you go. So I'm gonna add like a dot and kind of like below the center a little bit. It's not really centered right here, but like down here.
Yep.
And then I'm just gonna like create like a circle movement.
Swirl it.
Kind of swirl it just to make the dot a little bit more bigger.
Yep.
Yeah, so do that. And then I'm just gonna wipe like whatever's like left over here. And then I'm gonna make sure I wipe like.
Would you cure that or we just keep working?
I'll keep on working.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna wipe like the excess gel from the art liner brush.
Yep.
And then I'm gonna saturate the brush with the red color, and then I'm gonna create like the bow design. So sort of like this. I like to outline it first, so then I have like an idea of like filling it in after. So by outlining it, it creates like a perfect guideline for me to like figure out how it's gonna look like. Like so, if you could see.
Yeah, it looks good so far.
Yeah, I'm trying to like, I like to like balance my fingers onto like my elbows like on the table, and then my fingers on my other fingers just to have like a stable hand too.
Yeah. Okay. Well, it looks really great so far.
Oh, thank you so much. Okay. And then I'm just gonna fill in the empty spaces.
Okay.
To create that Hello Kitty bow. Like so.
Hey Sig.
Hi.
Can you remind us where those brushes come from again?
Yeah, so Rice Kitty is using our OPI Gel Artist Series brushes that are available at CosmoProfBeauty.com. Great question, thank you.
How many brushes does it come with again? Like, or like the name of the brushes?
So the question was, how many brushes are in the OPI Gel Color Artist Series toolkit? And there are a total of 4 brushes in this kit that comes with this really cute wallet, including the liner brush that she's using right now.
Yay. I just love the liner brushes. It's nice. It lays on the color really nicely.
Yeah, okay. It's really creamy.
Yeah, so once I created the bowl design, I'm gonna add it or place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds and let that cure.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Earlier we had just a comment about how much they loved your snowflake nail art. They said, love the addition of glitter as falling snow, and around others you can make some look like they're really in the foreground, in the background, playing with different sizes.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I just love glitter. Like, glitter is like on anything, like with no doubt, it just like makes everything more prettier.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. Mm-hmm. So if you're just joining us in this Live with Cosmo Prof, we are with Rice Kitty Nails, and she is demonstrating how to do a Hello Kitty bow nail art look.
Yes.
So if you have any questions for her on the technique that she's using or any of the shades from our brand new Hello Kitty collection, let us know in the comments below. And we also know, we'd love to know where you're watching from.
Yes. Okay, so once that is cured from the gel machine, I'm just gonna grab Hello Pretty and using this color to outline the bow to give it more depth to it. So I got that. And then I'm gonna clean the liner brush again just to make sure the color doesn't transfer, just to clean it up. And then saturate the liner brush just to make sure, like, everything, like, once you paint the design onto the nail, it's easier and it glides through nicely. So I'm gonna outline this O. Let's see. Outline like a circle in the center. Like so.
I'm getting a lot of questions on Facebook about somebody tuning in late or missing the first 30 minutes. No big deal. This live will be available for replay on Facebook, on Instagram, and on YouTube.
Yes.
Hey, Sig and Diana, just wanted to let you guys know we have a couple of new people watching from New York, Eastern Washington, North Carolina.
Yay.
And we had one question. Diana, how do you clean your nail art brushes?
Oh, I like to clean it with lint-free. I grab like a lint-free, pad, like a lint-free.
Start our expert touch.
Yeah,
lint-free wipes.
Nail wipes, and then I like to saturate that with alcohol, like so, and then kind of place it around the brush just to clean it up like this. So then, like, you have a clean brush.
Awesome.
To work with. Yeah.
Great question, thank you.
Yeah. I'll saturate the brush again. Okay, and then I'm gonna do an outline. I like this purple. It looks so pretty.
Yeah, it's really creamy.
Yeah, didn't you do like a design before too?
Yeah.
With using this color, like polka dots?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, so cute.
So don't forget, as Rice Kitty is finishing up her final nail art look, this is your last chance to enter 2 incredible giveaways. Where we will be giving away 5 full sets of our Hello Kitty collection in gel color. And for that, all you have to do is follow us on Instagram at @OPI_professionals and like Cosmo Prof on Facebook, and then tell us what your favorite shade in the collection is. For a chance to win the mini packs and nail lacquer, all you have to do is, again, follow us on Instagram at @OPI_professionals, like Cosmo Prof, and then tell us who you would gift the cute little stocking stuffer to.
Oh, those are so cute, the giveaways. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I finished outlining the bowl right now.
Yep.
And what makes like the design like iconic is that little like circle.
Yes.
Like half circle, like yep. at the end of the bowl.
Yep.
So I'm gonna also create that half circle, like so. And then do it on the other side as well.
Yep.
And then place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds.
Awesome.
Yay.
Yay.
I'm also gonna grab another red glitter, which is Dreamin' Glitter, what Sig has on her nails
yes.
too. But we're gonna add it into the bowl just to create like a cute glittery holiday effect to,
awesome.
To the Hello Kitty bowl.
I love a good Dada cure.
Yes. It's so pretty. Oh my God, this red. This is like more like, it has like different, oh, there's like small and then smaller ones.
Yeah, that one has a variety of different glitter specks in it, different sizes too,
oh.
which is really cool.
Okay, that's pretty.
Yeah.
Okay, so once that is cured into the gel machine, we're gonna take it out and then we're gonna add some of the glitter onto the red areas okay. of the bowl to give a sparkling effect to the nails.
Would this give a texture or would it remain pretty flat?
A little bit texture, okay. But I would say like a little bit flat.
Okay.
Yeah, so texture meaning like glitter effect.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it gives it like a nice glitter texture to the nail for sure.
Cool.
Yeah.
Someone on Instagram is saying hi from Germany.
Hi.
Okay, international.
Oh my God, I can't believe it's like from Germany and India, New York, everywhere. Oh my God. Wow, that's amazing.
How pretty
like,
cool, right?
How like social media is like connecting to people all over the world.
Yeah.
Like it's crazy. Okay, and then I'm gonna add glitter just to like the red areas to make it pop a little bit more.
Hey, Sig and Diana.
Hi.
I have a very serious question for you from Galdina.
Okay. Yes.
Is it possible to ever do too much glitter?
Is it possible to do too much glitter?
Never.
But I disagree.
Well, I guess like it depends on like the gel. Like if the gel has like a lot of like clear in it
yep.
like and you just want to get most of like the glitter
yeah.
what I like to do is just kind of add like some of the glitter onto the palette just to remove some of the extra gel and
yep.
just grab most of the glitter
flakes.
And then yeah just the glitter yep. flakes and place it onto like the nail if you don't want it too like lumpy or anything
right.
you just kind of trying to find a way to like right. place it like nice and flat onto the nail
yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, I loved so, her technique yeah. earlier where yeah. she kind of scooped out
mm-hmm.
those glitter specks and patted them onto the nail. That way you avoid undercuring issues
yeah.
too
mm-hmm.
as well.
Yeah, if it's like too thick, then it's going to create like that bubbly, ripply
yeah.
effect if
totally.
You carry into them. Yeah, if there's just too much. Yeah.
But so. Shine on, baby. Shine
on. Shine on, girl. You shine. Okay, so once I finish adding the glitter onto the bow, I'm going to place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds.
Awesome.
Yeah. And I'm just going to wipe the excess glitter from the brush.
Is that how you keep your nail brushes intact?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I just make sure to clean it all the time.
Awesome.
Yeah, just to, so then it doesn't contaminate your next design.
Oh, hey, Melissa just ordered those brushes.
Okay, girl.
Okay, girl.
Okay. Buy two more.
Yeah, we would love to see what nail art you create with the
yeah,
OPI
it's a great
series.
For gifts. Great
yeah.
for gifts and your friends. That's amazing. Oh my God. Yay.
If you are creating any nail art with OPI gel color or any of our franchises, make sure to tag us on Instagram at OPI_professionals.
Okay, awesome. So what I also like to do is like since the background kind of looks kind of plain, just to kind of glam it all up, I just feel like for Hello Kitty design, polka dots, stripes, yeah, your shirt, polka dots, perfect. I like to add it onto the nails just to create like this cutesy, like Hello Kitty inspired design. So
love
I'm
it.
Gonna grab Born to Sparkle
okay.
and add it to like the nail palette right here. And then I know like this glitter has like different like sizes,
yep.
But I try to grab like more of like the bigger sizes so you could see the glitter effect, polka dot effects onto the design. So I'm gonna grab like a dotting tool. And then,
yes,
let's see if you guys can see that.
Yep.
And then I'm gonna grab pieces of like the chunky glitter.
If you wouldn't mind just speaking up a little bit, because we all love learning your techniques.
Oh, yeah.
You get a little bit into your art.
Yeah,
so just be so helpful. Thank you.
Sometimes it gets serious when I do nails, but it's okay. It's okay. Okay, so what I like to do is grab a dotting tool and then grab some of the, like a piece of the glitter and place it onto the nail. So
it's so intricate.
Yeah, if the dotting tool doesn't work, I like to grab the liner, the liner brush.
Scoop it out?
Yeah, just gotta scoop it out from from the palette. So I grabbed one already.
Yay. Cool. 30 more to go.
Yeah, 30 more to go. But the end result is beautiful. Okay, so I placed that like so.
So pretty.
Yes, and then I'm just gonna kinda space it out a little bit. And grab a little bit more and space it out like so.
Diana, do you have any tricks for removing glittery nail polish? Because it takes forever, according to Telly.
On gel polish or on
she said nail polish?
Oh, nail polish? Oh, okay. So what I like to do is kind of like soak like a cotton ball onto acetone.
Okay.
Yeah, nail polish remover or acetone. And you could just place it on top of like the glitter nail. And after you place it, you could wrap it with foil and kind of like wait for like a minute or so. And then once it's like soaked and saturated with the acetone and you remove the foil away from the nail, you could, the glitter just removes easily. Like,
nice.
That's like another tip that I like to do.
Love it.
Yeah, instead of just like, I know glitter could be so hard to remove.
Grace Kitty, thank you so much for that tip. I do also want to point out that we have a really great tutorial on our YouTube channel about how to remove glitter. So if you want to see that in action, go ahead and head over to the YouTube channel.
Oh, that's amazing.
Awesome.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
You go. You can watch a video and learn at the same time.
Damn.
Yeah. All right, so then I'm going to continue adding the glitter.
Mm, she said thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, so we're going to add a little bit more glitter onto this design. And I'm placing it like a polka dot pattern. So I like to start from like upside down. Yeah, so from up and down. Oh, I think I got like some of the glitter. It's okay.
That's okay. Just show us how you fix it.
Oh yeah, I just kind of like brushed it off.
Cool.
Yeah.
That was easy.
Yeah.
No big deal.
Yeah, no big deal. And then I'm gonna grab more of the glitter and place it. I kind of like to like space it out just to like, so it won't look too like squished together. Cool. Like so. And sometimes I feel like whenever I'm doing nails, like I'm trying to talk at the same time, like multitasking, but
you're
it's okay.
You're doing a great job.
Thank you, I'm trying my best.
Yeah, you're getting lots of hard eyes on Instagram, so
I think that's
a good sign.
Yay!
Yeah.
Oh my God, look at this Hello Kitty bowl. Sometimes when I'm like looking at the design, like kind of close, like I can't see it, but when you kind of move back a little, you're like, oh my God, it looks nice.
Yeah, it looks beautiful.
Yeah. It's like zooming in really close and you can't really see the design. But if you move back a little bit, you see everything.
Yeah,
so
it's a little
nice.
Hard to work with glitter that way too. It's like shine on.
Yeah. Could be blindy. Get that bling, you know? Okay. I just need to add like a few more glitter dots. Like so. And there
someone said so meticulous.
I know.
Wow.
Okay, there you go. But it's all worth it.
Gorgeous.
Let's place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds and
awesome.
Let it cure.
Would you mind showing off the looks that you did go over today?
Yeah, sure, of course.
Words are hard.
So first, the first design that we showed is the sparkly glitter design. Oh, the sparkly glitter design. Let me move this so you can see it better.
Very good.
Okay, the sparkly glittery design. And then the second design that I showed you guys is the sparkly snowflakes.
Love it.
And last but not least, the Hello Kitty bow.
My favorite.
Yeah, and then lastly, I'm just gonna add one coat of top coat, just to seal everything together.
Cool.
And then place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds.
Beautiful.
Yes.
So most of the products you've seen today are definitely available at your local CosmoProf and CosmoProfBeauty.com.
Cool. Okay, I'm gonna place it into the gel machine for 30 seconds. And let that cure.
Awesome.
Yes.
One last question. Since these adorable designs take multiple colors, techniques, and brushes, curing, etc., mm-hmm. how would you price the nail art? I know a lot of nail artists find pricing to be difficult.
That's a really good question. I would say sometimes I see people like charge per minute.
Yeah.
So depending like how, like $1 per minute.
Yep.
So you could do it that way. Yep. But if you feel like it's too much, maybe like practice on the speed and then like look at the design in total. I mean, I would say like, I don't know, this could be like $3 per nail. And then this snowflake, it's a little bit more intricate.
Totally.
So I would say like maybe 10 or 12 per nail.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah, and then we got like the Hello Kitty bow. That is cute. Oh my God.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I guess for this design, maybe like 15 per nail.
Yeah. I mean, it's a lot of intricate work.
Yeah, a lot of intricate work. Yeah, because then you're like individually placing the glitter onto the nail, so it takes time. Imagine doing that on 10 fingers.
Bless you and the client that gets it, for sure.
Oh my God.
Diana, you did such a beautiful job
today.
Thank you for sharing your techniques and your artistry. For those of you who entered our giveaway, you'll be contacted directly if you won. Thank you for participating. Remind us again, what is your Instagram and how do we follow your work?
My Instagram is RiceKittyNails, and you can follow me on Instagram and Facebook.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And if you want to rewatch this live, definitely check out our YouTube channel, OPI Professionals, and then our Instagram, OPI_Professionals. We'll see you guys next time. Thank you, CosmoProf.
Bye, guys.